Right, okay. He was here for the GQ Men of the Year.
Mickey Rourke.
Last
yeah.
year. He was sat here.
Yeah.
He got up and he hit his head on that.
Oh no.
And that weighs, I can't even tell you what
it
this
looks
weighs.
Heavy.
It's so heavy.
Oh my goodness.
It's like, you feel that.
Oh, that's so
right?
heavy.
He knocked it off of there. He sat down. He had passed out. He had gone like as white as a sheet. And I
you
thought, oh my God,
Mickey
I'm the man who's nearly killed Mickey Rourke, you know. And he was sort of taking it light. He said, can I get some water? He said, oh, and it was like, here we go, more. And I thought, first of all, I think he's either going to sue us or he's going to laugh it off. Well, he kind of laughed it off.
Did he buy anything?
Oh yeah, he buys
did
quite
he?
A lot of
what did he buy?
You know, see, he's a sucker for a lady.
Okay.
So he buys stuff and then just gives it to all these girls.
Oh, does he?
Yeah,
what's his bauble of choice from Stephen
well,
Webster?
Well, he likes to buy things from our...
Mm-hmm. Show me, show me.
George Burns.
Show me.
Shall I show you?
Yeah.
So, let's see. Oh, you see this necklace here? He's bought mm-hmm. this twice. And both times giving it to his friends.
It's kind of like, oh, well.
But he's been so lovely. When we opened the shop, he came here and he did a little press call with us because he sort of became a friend as well.
Mm-hmm.
So. But we nearly killed him.
Yes. Yeah. I can't believe he got through the wrestler fighting scenes and then he comes into a jewellery shop and nearly dies.
Nearly dies, yeah.
So this is like all your kind of...
Well, everybody there's,
yeah.
you know, in some way or another, there's a client.
Tell me about Kate Moss.
Kate Moss, yeah, she's got a lobster ring on there.
Oh, yeah.
Which she was actually really wrestling my wife for, that one. And it was quite funny, because she was saying, what can I do? What can I do to get one? In typical Kate way. But over the years, you know, she's bought some things for me. She's bought several pairs of earrings and different stuff.
Because I think of her as someone who wears quite conservative jewelry.
Yeah,
like,
she's
classic,
not, it's funny, yeah, because she's not like, you never see her in like, you know, something that's making jewelry statements.
Right.
You know, some people do, some people don't. She doesn't really. But,
although the lobster, yeah. not exactly understated.
So like David Beckham here, he's got his rock star ring. This is cool. This is Jay-Z getting his Grammy, one of his Grammys, and he's got a couple of my dog tags on, which is nice because it was right in the middle of a time when, you know, the hip-hop guys was just blinging.
Yeah.
And this was a very different kind of statement. You know, these were a little bit more rock and roll and very understated. They're only silver.
Right.
So he's up there getting his big award and wearing just two silver dog tags, which was kind of interesting. And then, you know, I mean, it's not something I'm sure she wants to talk about now, but I made the Coles... wedding rings.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. What do they look like?
They were really cool. Actually, hers was mega. It was like a 9-carat heart-shaped canary yellow diamond as a wedding ring. It wasn't even the engagement ring.
That's amazing.
And his was pretty neat. It was one of my, like, form bands. And then Ozzy Osbourne, he's got quite a lot of our jewellery.
Does he buy it? Does
Yeah, he does.
The
Mrs. really
buy it.
Buys it, pays for it, loves it.
Seriously?
Yeah. And
have you ever custom-made a thing for
yeah,
him?
Yeah, totally. That ring now... I
mean, it's like a star ring.
Yeah, but I used to make that ring. Oh, you see this?
Mm-hmm.
Right, that
is
how I designed it first.
Ah.
So it had no diamonds, and I cut a stone into a star.
Mm-hmm.
And even though it was a rock star ring, it wasn't...
Mm-hmm.
It was quite... It's funny, and it's quite understated in a way. It wasn't blinging. So I get this phone call, and... it was from Maxfield's in LA, and they said, one of our clients, he wants that ring, that rock star ring you wear, he wants the middle stone to be a ruby and diamonds. And I said, you know, that's going to be crazy. They said, just give us a quote. So I give him a quote. It's like, it's going to be something like $100,000. Go for it. And I'd not dealt with Maxfield's very long or anything. I said, this is a real order. Yeah, it's a real order. He said, the guys who shop here are crazy.
Yeah.
and it was for Ozzy Osbourne, which I didn't know until I saw him on the front cover of Rolling Stone magazine, right when that Osbournes had kind of
as
the new show, you
yeah.
know. And he was suddenly about to become really known as opposed to being the sort of the bat-biting lead singer of Black Sabbath.
Right. That's amazing there, because you may never have found out. Like, that would be quite frustrating,
well,
right?
Well, you know, I've met him now a lot of times, but I didn't know then. And that can happen a lot. I mean, like, Pink, I made her wedding rings, and she's got loads of my jewellery, and, you know, she became a friend as well. And Russell Brand up there, decked out in our stuff.
Is he like your alter ego?
Well, he's a funny guy. I really like him, man. She's so funny.
And Madonna, so, did you make Madonna's wedding?
Yeah,
What does that,
she's wearing there. Mm-hmm. That in some ways was one of the most significant things for me, more than the wedding rings, because mm-hmm. I had no celebrity clients. I was a business of
Seriously?
One person. And I met her and she bought that ring. And it was, I was showing you the turquoise ring.
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah.
I'll show you exactly the ring.
Because it looks like your ring, the one she's wearing. It's like a dark stone band kind of thing.
Only in black.
Wow.
And so she buys the ring and I hear nothing. So, I could tell people. I go, Madonna's got one of my rings, which was cool. But there was nothing. I was getting Chinese takeaway, right? And I'm waiting for it. And I open the Daily Mirror and that picture, Guy Ritchie's next to her. And it was right... He'd just made Lock Stock. They'd just seen them together.
Yeah.
And she's got a glass of champagne and she's got my ring on the finger. And I'm like, oh my God, that's amazing.
Yeah.
And it went out like, you can't believe. I have InStyle magazine. Everybody's like, that's one of your Crystal Age rings, isn't it? They sort of know these things. How, I don't know, but they know. And it just sort of went like wildfire. And then there was a period in New York where, like, everybody... bought that ring.
I really?
It was crazy. I couldn't make enough of it. And of course, they all want to wear it on this finger.
Right.
Because
that's quite unusual, right? On the index.
Because that was, like 12 years ago or something like that. And I'd been making the ring already for a while, but it was like right under the radar, no one knew. So that was sort of quite significant.
That's amazing. But that wasn't her wedding ring?
No, I made that as well.
But was that bespoke?
Yeah, and that was really very understated.
Was it?
Yeah, because her engagement ring was this sort of vintage Victorian, like, I want to say 5 stone, it was about 5 stone, sort of typical. Mm. There was a style of ring that would have had a bigger one in the middle and then gradually get smaller in a line.
Quite
rather than a classic. Yeah, it was totally, totally classic. And I had to make a ring to go with it.
Right.
So, I'm good at doing things like, if I need to make a traditional twist on something, I can do it. And so I made a very engraved, hand-engraved, beautiful wedding ring. Which, funny, I've just made David Walliams and Lara's wedding rings. And I made him a ring, nothing like Madonna's, but he's a very traditional guy.
Right.
And so he's like, he comes to me a bit, okay, so what do I do? And I said, look, you know what, leave it with me. Let me draw up a few things, and I did a ring that was very engraved, hand engraved, beautiful,
oh, wow.
A bit like you would do a gun.
Oh right, yeah.
And he loves it, and it's that sort of thing that you've got to wear it. Hopefully, I want to say for the rest of your life, at least for a long time, and you've got to love it. You've got to love your wedding ring, because if you don't, you're just not gonna. You're gonna look for reasons not to wear it. And I made her a very simple diamond band, but it looked beautiful. Yeah. She's got tiny little finger size.
Oh, really?
She's quite big, but she's got tiny fingers. And it looked great. But, so quite conservative. And that often is the case. When people, it's a bit like I said with Russell Brand, he can buy all my jewellery, and Katy Perry be buying his Christmas present, they go and get engaged, go Cartier. But I kind of understand.
Yeah.
I think they think that I'm only going to make them wear a lobster ring, which of course I wouldn't. I would make it whatever they wanted or I would say, look, how about this or this?
That's great.